Good morning, teacher.
Hello, good morning. Okay, so welcome everybody. Thank you for being here on time. Well, today we have to talk about what? What is the topic today? What is the topic? Describe?
Describe your diet.
Your diet. What is describe your diet in Spanish?
Describir.
Describir.
Lógica, tu dieta.
Exactly, very good. So, describir tu dieta. It's okay, describe your diet. Excellent. So, today, we have how much, how many? Okay, we have how much, how many? We have count and non-count nouns, okay? So, let's start here. Okay, so, give me a second, please. Okay, so, the eat well plate. This is called the eat well plate. The eat well plate helps you to eat a healthy diet. It shows the types of food to eat and also how much of each type of food to eat. Okay, so let's see. Give me 1 second. Okay, so what is the eat well plate? How do you say eat well plate in Spanish? The eat well plate. What is eat well plate? Miluska, Catherine, hello, the rest. Eat well plate. What is a plate?
Disculpe, teacher, no lo escuché.
How do you say eat well plate in Spanish?
Plato de.
What is eat?
Comer, cierto?
Uh-huh.
El verbo comer.
Uh-huh. And well.
Bien, plato bueno, comida o una buen plato.
Yes, it's eat well plate. It's like a plato de comida saludable.
Saludable.
Okay. Good. So in this plate here, this is the plate, the eat well plate. Okay. What are the food you see? So give me 1 second. I have to admit. Okay. So here, for example, repeat after me, lettuce.
Letters.
Okay.
Letters.
Letters.
Okay. One letters. More time. One more time. Letters.
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 Bananas.
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 Uh-huh. Broccoli.
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 Broccoli. Orange.
Orange.
Apple.
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 Tomatoes.
Tomatoes.
Cabbage.
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 No, no, no. Cabbage, no es cabeche, eh. No sé por qué es cabeche. Okay. One more time, one more time. Cabbage.
Cabbage.
Ajá, uh-huh, good. Carrots.
Carrots.
Mm-hmm. Good. Now here, popcorn.
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 Bread.
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 Rice.
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 Potatoes.
Potatoes.
Pasta.
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 Okay. Here, cheese.
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 Milk.
Milk.
Butter.
Butter.
Yogurt.
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 Mm-hmm. Very good. Now here we have candy.
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 Cookies.
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 Good. Beans.
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 Meat.
Meat.
Eggs.
Eggs.
Fish.
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 Good. Okay. How do you say lettuce in Spanish? What is a lettuce?
Lechuga.
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 Lechuga. Excellent. Bananas.
Plátano.
Broccoli.
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 No, this is difficult, no? Broccoli. Orange.
Naranja.
Naranja.
Apple.
Manzana.
Tomatoes.
Tomate.
Tomate.
Uh-huh. Tomates, in plural. Carrots.
Zanahoria.
Zanahorias.
Zanahorias, plural. Cabbage.
Col. Col.
Uh-huh. What is cabbage?
Col.
Col. Col.
Col, yes. Col, col. Mm-hmm. Here, popcorn.
Canchita.
La canchita. Popcorn. Bread.
Pan.
Pan.
Pan. Uh-huh. Rice.
Arroz.
Arroz.
Arroz. Potatoes.
Papa.
Papas.
Papas, plural. Pasta.
Fideos.
Fideos.
Well, pasta is pasta, huh?
Pasta.
Okay, pasta is pasta. And kinds of, okay, types. What is type in Spanish? Type.
Tipo.
Tipo.
Tipo, okay. Now, type of pasta is, for example, spaghetti, okay, or tallarin, and more and more and more. Okay, lasagna. Lasagnas are types of pasta, okay? Pasta is a general term. Now, cheese. What is cheese?
Queso.
Queso.
Queso. Milk.
Leche.
Leche.
Butter.
Tequila.
Yogurt.
Yogurt.
Candy.
Dulces.
Caramelos.
Caramelos.
Yeah, caramelo. Yeah, caramelo candy. Cookies.
Galletas.
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 Mm-hmm. Beans.
Beans.
Frijoles.
Frijoles, ajá. Uh-huh. Very good. Frijolitos. Okay. Fish.
Pescado.
Eggs.
Huevos.
Meat.
Carne.
Carne.
De res.
Well, carne, yeah. Carne, in general, in general. Okay, because meat is carne. In this case, is like the res, right? That you have, for example, chicken meat. But it's chicken, okay? Only chicken. Okay, so, see, 1 second. Okay, now, here, did you watch the videos? Did you watch the videos? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. So the videos were for count nouns. Count nouns and? Non-count nouns. Okay. So please, Miluska, can you help me here? Read, please. Have, count nouns, have.
Have a singular, a plural. One apple, two apples.
Very good, very good. Thank you. Thank you, Miluska. So, count nouns have singular and?
A plural.
And plural. For example, one apple, two
apples.
Okay? Count nouns, singular and plural. Is this clear? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. Now, please, Maribel, continue here. Count nouns take
a singular and plural verbs. The apple is red. The apple are red.
Thank you. So, singular and plural?
Verbs.
Okay. In this sentence, the apple is red. What is the verb? The apple is red. What is the verb?
Is.
Very good. In this case, is it singular or plural?
Singular.
And in the apples are red, what is the verb?
Are,
right? And are is
plural.
Is this clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, yes. Now remember, this is for count nouns, okay? Singular and plural, one apple, two apples, and singular and plural verbs is are. Now, please, Cindy, can you help me here? Non-count nouns.
Only have a singular water.
Mm-hmm. Only have a singular. Okay, only singular. For example, water. So it's possible two waters?
No.
Mm-hmm. Okay, only singular. Okay, please, Hermes Hector, help me here.
Only take singular verbs. The water is hot.
Good. So in this case, count nouns, singular and plural verbs. Non-count nouns, only singular. Yes? For example, the water is hot. Is this clear?
Yes.
Okay, good. Can you give me one more example for count nouns? Examples for count nouns. Hello, examples.
Or bananas.
Okay, bananas, for example. Bananas, good. Oranges. Okay, excellent. So, bananas is singular or plural? Bananas?
Plural.
And what is a singular form?
Banana.
Banana, right?
Banana.
Banana. Okay. So, it has singular and plural. And oranges is plural or singular?
Plural.
What is the singular form?
Orange.
Okay, singular and plural. Okay. Now, can you give me examples for non-count nouns?
Milk.
Very good, very good. So, example, milk. Other example?
Yogurt.
Yogurt. Cereal, for example. Good. Okay. Cereal is non-count. Okay. It is count cuando. When is count cereal?
A box.
Ah, when it's in a box. Here. A box of cereal. So, this a box is count. Yes? Is this clear?
Yes.
Good. So, let's continue, okay?
Teacher, una consulta.
Yes.
La asistencia está, tenemos que poner en la plataforma.
No, continue. You have to continue here in Zoom. You have to write it here in Zoom.
Entonces ya no se pone yo.
No, no, si yo lo digo, sé que yo lo digo.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Let's continue. Okay. Now, here we have an activity. Activity A. Please, Joaquin, help me. Write.
Write the foods from above in the correct column.
Uh-huh. What is above? Above. Here, what is above?
Encima.
Arriba. Arriba. Okay. So what foods? The above foods. So these foods here. Okay? You have to use these foods here. Milk, rice, bread, orange, and complete this chart. Is this clear? Yes?
Yes.
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 Okay, so, let's see. Okay, now you can do this activity in groups, okay? Let's do this activity in groups, please. You have to speak, okay, and do the activity in groups together, okay? And speaking, not telepathy, please, okay? Is this clear?
Yes.
Okay, thank you so much, please. Communicate with your mouth, okay? Not with your mind. Telepathy, not telepathy, please, okay?
So,
yeah, no, please. Okay, excellent. So, go, join your groups. Go, 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 join your groups.
dar son como que pastillitas, creo.
No, son frijoles.
Ah, no. Entonces, eso no se puede contar.
Tomatoes.
La carne sí, ¿no?
Creo que sí. No, no. Si fuera un kilo de carne, creo que ahí sí es contable.
Entonces la carne no iría.
Otro puede ser apple and bala.
Otro puede ser beans y butter.
Yeah. Puede ser
teacher, ya acabamos. Estamos esperando que nos salga.
Creo que eso, ¿qué más iría? Solo ya lo separamos, ¿no?
Sí, ya lo separamos.
Ya, entonces. No, sí voy a barrer, espera.
Okay. Excellent. So let's see. Label the foods with countable or non-countable. Okay. So eggs, potatoes, oranges, apple. They are countable or non-countable?
Countable.
Rice, lettuce, broccoli, cabbage.
Non-countable.
Cheese, yogurt, butter, milk.
Non-countable.
Bread, meat, fish, beans, candy.
Non-countable.
And tomatoes, carrots, bananas, cookies.
Countable.
Let's see. Good. Very good. Excellent. Perfect. Okay, now let's continue. Okay, so this is clear. Now we have the grammar for how much and how many. Okay, did you watch the video for how much and how many?
Mm-hmm.
Yes? So my question is, when do we use how much?
Uncountable.
Very good. When we have an uncountable noun. Countable noun. Okay, good. Okay, excellent. For example, in this case, here, How much? For milk.
Milk.
Okay, milk is? Non-count. Okay, so non-count or uncountable is the same. Okay?
Lo mismo.
It's the same, no problem. Non-count or uncountable. And how many?
Countable.
Countable. The opposite. For countable nouns or count nouns. Okay, for example, in this case?
Yes.
Oranges. Yes. Yes, is this clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Entonces, okay. Como many es algo más específico.
No, no more specific. It's for or for count nouns. So sustantivos que se pueden contar. Okay, and how much is for the opposite, sustantivos que no pueden contarse. Okay. Now please, Gonzalo Jesús Luyo. Here, please.
How much money are you said to ask about question?
Questions?
Quantities.
Very good. So how much and how many are used, son usados, to ask? What is to ask?
Para preguntar.
Sobre
cantidades.
Cantidades. Okay. Is this clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. If I want to say cuánto pan, how do you say cuánto pan in English?
How much bread?
Very good. Why how much bread?
But
bread. How much? Why? How much? Why not how many bread?
But it's uncountable.
It is uncountable. Okay, good. And if I want to say cuántos tomates hay? O cuántos tomates? How do you say in English?
How many? Tomatoes.
Tomatoes.
Good. How many tomatoes? Excellent. Good job. So is this clear? Is this clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, excellent. Good. Now we have some exercises here in activity A. Okay. Please, Jasmine Lynn Espinosa. Help me, please. Complete
the sentence. Use how much or how many?
Very good. Thank you, Jasmine Lee. Okay, so complete the sentences with how much and how many. Okay, they can depend on how much and how many. So for what? For the
plural.
Nouns.
Very good. So nouns, if it's count or the opposite, non-count. Mm-hmm. Is this clear?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
This activity is individually. So please complete the activity. You have 3-4 minutes to complete the activity.
Oh.
Let's go.
How much?
Individually. Did you finish?
Yes.
Yes.
Excellent. Yes. So, number one. Eggs, do you eat every week?
How many
or how much?
How many?
Why? Why how many? Okay, X
is countable.
It's countable now. Good. Okay, speak in English, no problem. Okay, so how many? Excellent. Now, blah 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 meat do you eat every week?
How much?
Good. Okay. Fruit juice, how much? Good.
How much?
Cookies.
How many?
And bread?
How much?
Okay, excellent. So everybody, please repeat after me. How many eggs do you eat every week?
How many eggs do you eat every week?
How much meat do you eat every week?
How much meat do you eat every week?
Good. How much fruit juice do you drink every day?
How much fruit juice do you drink every day?
Mm-hmm. How many cookies do you eat every day?
How many cookies do you eat every day?
Good. How much bread do you eat every day?
How much bread do you eat every day?
Good. Excellent. So, any questions?
No.
No.
Yes.
Bread, si es comestible.
Bread?
Okay.
What, bread is countable?
No. O sea, es pan, ¿cierto?
Yes, es pancito.
El pancito sí se puede contar.
El pancito se puede contar, but here in Peru. Okay, because pancito is like, in the United States, they don't usually have pancito separados. They have pancito like pan de molde in un paquete. Entonces ahí se cuenta por paquetes, por packs. O también como vas a aprender ayer, loaf. A loaf of bread.
Allá no así individual.
No. Now in English.
Yes.
Okay, because pancito is in Peru or in Spanish, pancito se cuenta. Porque nosotros compramos un pan, dos panes, tres panes, pero they don't have one pancito or two pancitos. Okay, they have packs, paquetes.
Entendí.
Yeah, good question.
It's clear.
Very good, Jasmine, excellent. I like it, I like the question. Okay, excellent. Well, let's continue then. Let's continue. With a conversation. Yes?
Teacher.
Yes, what?
Teacher.
Yes.
Disculpe, una pregunta.
Yes, what's your question?
¿Cómo hago en el caso de las cantidades?
The quantities.
Por decir, un kilo.
Okay, ¿cómo haces con ello?
¿Cómo gramos o integramos?
¿Cómo harías para preguntar? ¿No? ¿Cuál es tu pregunta? O sea, ¿cuál es el problema con los kilos y con la food, con la comida?
¿Cómo lo diría?
Okay, esa es la pregunta. Okay, excellent. So, you can say, for example, in Spanish, how do you say it?
Por ejemplo, un kilo de carne.
Okay, pero what is the question? ¿Cuál es la pregunta que quisieras que decir? A ver, for example. ¿Como cuántos kilos de carne, algo así?
Ajá.
Okay, so, for example, carne. Vamos a comenzar con carne, okay? Carne is countable or uncountable? Everybody, yeah? Everybody. Meat is countable or uncountable?
Uncountable.
So, cuando quiero saber quantity for meat, is how much or how many? How much? Okay. How much meat do you eat? ¿Cuánta carne comes? Okay. Aquí la respuesta, tú tienes que, hay varias, formas de darlas, pero voy a dar una de ellas. I eat 1 kilo, 1 kilogram of meat a week. Okay. So in this case, meat is countable or uncountable in the answer?
Countable.
Why? Porque es 1 kilogram. Okay, ese de aquí es 1 kilogram. Es una unidad de medida. Okay. So you can use 1 kilogram of meat. Ya es countable this. Ya no es meat in general. Se convirtió en 1 kilo. Okay. Other example. También puedo hacerle la pregunta. So, how many kilograms of meat do you eat? How many kilograms of meat do you eat? Do you eat every week? So, in this case, meat is count or non-count now?
Count.
Uh-huh. Why? Because it's kilograms. Kilograms of meat. Not kilogram in general. It's specific kilograms. Is this clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Sí. Esa es una situación cuando te preguntan de persona a persona si quieres comprar carne en una situación.
For example, si tú no quieres decir o no dices la cantidad, you don't say kilograms. Puedes decir, for example, can you buy meat? What is can you buy meat in Spanish?
¿Cuánto cuesta la carne?
¿Puedes comprar carne? Okay, vamos a crear una mini conversation, okay?
Pero si estoy con el carnicero, por ejemplo, ¿cuánto me vale un kilo de carne? O si quiero hacer las compras para el súper, por ejemplo.
Ajá, por ejemplo, entonces si tú le dices, dame carne, ¿no? Te tira toda la carne que tiene ahí.
Un kilo.
Entonces ahí es diferente, ¿no? Depende de la situación, de la situación y depende de lo que quieras tú preguntar también, cuál es la intención, ¿no? Ok. For example, can you buy meat? Que una mamá le dice a su hija, ¿no? Está yendo al mercado a su hija y dice, can you buy meat? Su hija responde, yes. Ok, pero va a ir así al carnicero a decir, véndeme carne. How much? ¿Cuánta? So, va a hacer una pregunta, ¿no? Entonces, la hija le pregunta a su mamá, how much meat do we need? How do you say this in Spanish? How much meat do we need?
Necesitamos,
ajá. Ok, esa es una de las formas. Otra pregunta podría haber sido también, how many, pero tengo que agregar algo aquí, porque meat is non-count. So, how many?
Kilograms.
Ok. How many kilograms of meat do we need? Ahí ya cambió, ¿ven? ¿Cuántos kilos de carne necesitamos? Ok, pero ¿qué pasa si yo no sé si son kilos? De repente son solamente 200 gramos, ¿no? Entonces, por eso justamente uno no pregunta por kilos todavía, pues. Solo pregunta en general, ¿cuánta carne? Ok, porque tú no sabes si va a ser en kilos, si va a ser en toneladas, si va a ser en gramitos, hectogramos, o sea, hay un montón de opciones. Entonces, por eso solo se pregunta, ¿how much meat? O sea, en general, ¿cuánta carne?
¿Cuánto
está el
kilo de carne?
¿Y qué le puede responder a la mamá? ¿No? ¿Cuánto kilo de carne le pregunta? ¿O cuánta carne le pregunta la hija? ¿La mamá le puede responder? ¿2 kilograms? ¿Ok? ¿Es this clear?
¿Cómo le pregunta al vendedor? O sea,
okay, al vendedor.
¿Tiene 2 kilogramos de carne?
¿Ok? Ok, vamos a ponerle yo tengo acá al amigo casero, ¿no? Acá, se llama Jorge. ¿Ya? So, Jorge, Jorge vende carne, so if I want to go, yo quiero ir donde Jorge y le quiero pedir, ¿no? Quiero comprar carne. Entonces yo me acerco y digo, hello, hello. Hi, Jonathan. Hi, Jorge. ¿Qué podría decirle yo a Jorge?
¿Cuánto está el kilo de carne?
¿Cuánto está el kilo de carne?
Ajá. Ok, ese es un... No, todavía no he aprendido, pero lo vamos a poner aquí. Okay. How much does meat cost? Okay. How much? Okay. How much does meat cost? ¿Cuánto cuesta la carne? Okay. But this is not Jorge. This is Jonathan, right? Yo pregunto. And Jorge answers. Jorge answers. What is the answer for Jorge?
Yes, that is el kilos.
Okay, okay. Imagine, okay?
That one kilogram.
Okay, 20 soles. Okay, or maybe this. 1 kilogram is 20 soles. Okay, y él me puede hacer una pregunta también, ¿no? Como de ese que ya me dio la información. 1 kilo, 20 soles. ¿Qué me puede preguntar él?
¿Cuántos kilos?
Very good. How many or how much? Pero ahí voy a tener que variar en algo. Si uso how many, lo que sigue tiene que ser countable. Si uso how much, es algo general. No necesariamente tiene que ser countable, sino uncountable. Okay? Vamos a usar how much primero. How much. How much?
Meat.
Meat. Ya me está preguntando a mí, ¿eh? Do you?
Do you need?
Ajá. Okay, very good. Okay, this is one option. Okay, how much meat do you need? Other option is how many?
1 kilogram. No. How many kilograms?
Kilograms.
Do you need?
Yeah, es lo mismo, solo cambia en kilograms porque es countable. And in this caso, meat in general is non-countable. So how much? Okay, is this clear?
Entonces, si va many, tendría que ir la cantidad específica.
Exactly, yes. Si tú usas carne y quieres usar con how many, tienes que convertir esa carne en contable. ¿Cómo? Con cantidades. Quantities.
One kilogram,
100 grams. ¿Ok? En cambio es más fácil si yo voy solamente por la fruta, ¿no? El frutero. Oranges. It's easy. 1 orange, 2 oranges. ¿Ok? The problem maybe is for non-countable meat, milk. Okay, is this clear?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, very good, excellent. Okay, now let's go with a conversation. Okay, and you have to listen to the conversation. Ready?
Yes.
Okay, you don't have to repeat, just pay attention to the pronunciation, maybe new words, new vocabulary. Okay, let's go.
Tell me about the food you eat. How much fruit do you eat? I eat an apple every day. Sometimes I have an orange as well. Very good. Do you eat meat? Yes, I love meat. How much meat do you eat? I eat a big steak every day. And vegetables. Do you eat any vegetables? No, I don't like vegetables.
Okay, one more time. Listen.
Tell me about the food you eat. How much fruit do you eat? I eat an apple every day. Sometimes I have an orange as well. Very good. Do you eat meat? Yes. I love meat. How much meat do you eat? I eat a big steak every day. And vegetables. Do you eat any vegetables? No, I don't like vegetables.
Good. Excellent. So what is the problem with the patient? And what is patient in Spanish?
Paciente.
Paciente, uh-huh. Good. So what is the problem with the patient? Does the patient eat well? Yes or no?
No.
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 Not really.
No.
A big steak. What is a big steak?
Chuleta.
Bistec. Bistec grande every day. Wow. And vegetables?
No comen.
No vegetables. No vegetables. Okay. ¿Y a quién no le gusta aquí? Levanta su mano a vegetables. No, everybody? Okay, good. Good, very good, very good. Okay, excellent. So everybody, repeat after me. Tell me about the food you eat.
Tell me about the food you eat.
How much fruit do you eat?
How much fruit do you eat?
I eat an apple every day.
I eat an apple every day.
Sometimes I have an orange as well. Very good.
Very good. One more time.
Very good.
Very good.
Do you eat meat? Yes, I love meat.
Yes, I love meat.
How much meat do you eat?
How much meat do you eat?
I eat a big steak every day.
I eat a big steak every day.
And vegetables? Okay, now for this, is it blah 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 blah? No, it's vegetables. Okay. So the correct pronunciation is vegetables. Very good, vegetables. Okay, do you eat any vegetables?
Do you eat any vegetables?
No, I don't like vegetables.
No, I don't like vegetables.
What? I sound like what? One more time. No, I don't like vegetables. Uh-huh, very good. Okay, cuidado con tables, huh? Tables and mesa. All right, good, excellent. Now I'm gonna teach you a trick. Okay, un truquito. I'm gonna teach you a trick. Y ya les había enseñado eso, pero hay que recordar que siempre se puede usar. Okay, so tell me about the food. Food you. Okay, siempre cuando tengan consonant en vowel, pueden unir. Okay, pero hablando de sounds, ¿ah? Sounds. Okay. Food you. So tell me about the food you eat. Okay. How much fruit do you eat? No, in this case, no. I eat. Eaten. I eat an apple.
I eat an apple.
Very good. Every day. Sometimes I have an orange. Good. Very good. Do you eat meat? Yes, I love meat. How much meat do you eat? I eat a big steak every day. Steak every. Okay? I eat a big steak every day. Okay? and vegetables, do you eat? Do you eat any? Eat any? Do you eat any vegetables? No, I don't like vegetables. Is this clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, so repeat after me. Food you.
Food you.
Food you.
Food you, food you, food you. No, food you. Food you.
Food you.
Aha, very good. Good sound. Food you.
Food you. Food.
Tell me about the food you eat.
Tell me about the food you eat.
Okay, good. I eat an apple every day. Yeah, every day, sorry. Go. 1, 2, 3.
I eat an apple
every day.
Good. Sometimes I have an orange. Okay, very good. Here, I eat a big steak every day.
I eat a big steak every day.
Lo que estoy haciendo aquí es unir sonidos más no reducir nada, ¿eh? No quiere decir que como junto digo steak. No, steak no es. Que steak es este de aquí. Stay. Nathan is stay. It's state. No, steak. Steak every day.
Every day.
Que no reduzcan sonido, solo se juntan, eh. Okay, so one more time. I eat a big steak every day.
I eat a big steak every day.
Very good. Good. Do you eat any vegetables? Very good, excellent. Now you have to practice this conversation in
groups.
Okay, excellent. Are you ready?
Yes.
Please, you have to practice speaking one more time, okay? Please, it's not correct to practice with telepathy, okay? Are you ready?
Yeah.
Go. Join your groups, please.
Ahí está.
¿Cómo empezamos?
Ya, a ver, de dos, y de ahí vamos rotando.
¿Ya quién empieza? Yeah. ¿Quién doctor? ¿Quién pasa?
How much meat do you eat?
I eat a big steak every day.
Tell me about the food you eat. How much fruit do you eat?
Está bien.
Yeah.
Sí, de todos modos, cualquier cosa lo voy corrigiendo. Supone que estamos aquí para aprender.
Yeah.
Sí. Steak every day. Vegetable, do you eat any vegetable?
No, I don't like vegetables.
A ver, ahora al revés. Lidia.
Ya, yo empiezo, yo soy el doctor. Ya. Tell me about the food you eat. How much fruit do you eat?
I eat an apple every day. Sometimes I have an orange as well.
Very good. Do you eat meat?
Yes, I love meat.
How much meat do you eat?
I eat a big steak
Very good. Do you eat meat?
Yes, I love meat.
An apple every day. Sometimes I have an orange as well.
Very good. Do you eat meat?
Ya predicamos.
Oh, qué pena. Oh, okay, one more time, please.
Uno. Ya, a ver. Un rato.
Yo empiezo.
Okay.
Ya.
Yeah. Tell me about the food you eat. How much fruit do you eat?
I eat an apple every day. Sometimes I have an orange as well.
Very good. Do you eat meat?
Yes, I love meat.
How much meat do you eat?
I eat a big steak every day.
Vegetables, do you eat any vegetables?
No, I don't like vegetables.
Good, very good, thank you.
Yes.
Okay, very good. So, al haber llegado a Basic 3, creo que han ganado el derecho de olvidarse de las what to task. So, vamos a practicar, let's practice, la canción que hizo que todos canten a what to task. Okay.
No.
Vamos a practicar this song. Así que el what to task se va a ir, nunca más volverá.
Ah, así se llamaba.
Sí, así se llamaba. No, what to task no se llamaba.
Después vamos a estar como cachín ahí.
No, what to task no se llamaba.
Cachín tenía mucho flow, ese fue el problema.
Ah, exacto. Ok. So, vamos a escuchar. Voy a poner primero para que traten allí de escuchar, recordar de repente cómo va el ritmo. Ok. Y luego vamos a practicar pronunciation, como lo hemos hecho antes. Y, ok, voy a ir indicándole. Ready?
Ready.
Okay. Yes. Escuchen la diferencia de la guarda tuta francesa.
No sé.
Porque está comenzando, pues. ¿Qué tal el what to task? No era, ¿no? Ese no era, ¿no?
Ya no era más.
No, toda la vida engañados.
Another
one, okay. Bites the dust.
The dust, ajá. Ajá, es una diferencia, ¿no? El what to task con another one bites the dust.
One bites
the piedra.
Okay.
¿Qué significa, teacher?
Vamos a ir traduciendo poquito, ¿ok? Para que entienda el sentido de la canción. Ahora, ¿por qué canciones? ¿Okay? ¿Por qué canciones? Porque tiene, como les he explicado, tiene un ritmo, tiene melodía. Entonces, ¿qué pasa? Cuando yo pronuncio, por ejemplo, manzana, ¿cuántos tiempos debería usar en manzana?
Three.
Manzana, hay tres, ¿no? Ahora, en la música, esas tres sílabas pueden ocupar diferentes tiempos porque las alargo más, ¿no? Entonces, si uno pronuncia una palabra incorrectamente, la pronuncia mal, ¿okay? Se sale del tiempo. Entonces uno se da cuenta inmediatamente, es como una autocorrección. En cambio, cuando uno solamente lee, no sabe si está pronunciando bien o mal, ¿okay? Pero aquí la música, como automáticamente te dice, te saliste, del tono, no solamente si es más alto o más agudo, más grave, no. Sino te saliste del tiempo. ¿Okay? Y cuando sale el tiempo es porque estás pronunciando algo que no está bien.
Pero ¿okay? Todo se pronuncia rápido, profesor.
Pero es el ejercicio, ¿ve? No puedes comenzar tú a hablar rápido si es que no comienzas a practicar, pues. Sí. Okay, van a ver que va a ser fácil, ¿eh? Okay. Okay, pero ¿están dispuestos? ¿Están listos o no?
Yes.
Okay, excellent. Esa es la actitud.
Ready.
Okay, let's go. Okay, acá, vamos, comenzamos aquí. Okay. So, lo único que tenemos que hacer en las canciones, aparte de pronunciar correctamente, es la fluidez. Para encontrar la fluidez es conectar las palabras como les acabo de enseñar. Okay, repeat after me. Stop. Sorry. Steve walks warily.
Steve walks warily.
Uh-huh. Aquí no hay nada que conectar, así que solo Steve walks warily down the street.
Down the street.
Tienen que en primer lugar tener, ustedes esa canción la han escuchado, ¿cierto? Entonces sí la saben cómo va el tonito. Entonces es tan 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 tan. Entonces tienen que pronunciar en esos tiempos y en esos momentos las palabritas, ¿ok? Tan 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 tan, ¿ok? So Steve walks warily down the street.
Buen cantante.
Steve walks warily down the street with the bird.
Okay. No, relax.
Yo nunca me estuve en un coro antes.
Ese es un tema aparte. Okay. Repeat after me. Steve walks warily down the street.
Steve walks down the street.
Okay, vamos a concentrarnos en solo pronunciation ahora, no en tiempo, okay? Steve walks warily down the street.
Steve walks warily down the street.
Very good. One more time. Steve walks warily down the street.
Steve walks warily down the street.
Good. Okay. Vamos a aumentar a ver ahora solamente el tararatan tarataratá, ya. Sin tarareando nada más, sin el pronunciation de Steve. Tom. Ahora olvídense de esto de acá. Okay. Lo repitan conmigo. Tan 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 ta tan tan tan. Ajá, good. One more time. Tan 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 tan
tan tan tan tan tan tan.
Okay, ahora un poco más rápido. Tan 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 tan
tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan.
No, pero si van a hacer no, se van a perder en el tono de la canción. Okay. No, y no estoy hablando de que su voz sea más agudita, más grave. No, no importa. Solamente el saber si sube o baja, sube o baja. No, okay. Entonces, tan 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 tan
tan tan tan tan tan tan tan.
Okay, okay. Tan 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 tan. Okay, okay. Ahora regresamos a la pronunciación sin tiempo, sin nada, solamente pronunciation. Steve walks warily down the street.
Steve walks warily down the street.
Ah, recuerden que esa de acá está L, no se pronuncia, ¿eh? Eso lo Steve walks. Steve walks warily down the street.
Down the street.
Okay, good. So now, vamos a combinar los soniditos, okay, junto a pronunciation con el tono, okay? So, repeat after me. Steve walks warily down the street.
Steve walks warily down the street.
Okay, one more time. Steve walks warily down the street.
Steve walks warily down the street.
Good. Vamos a aumentar la velocidad nada más. Stick walks wearily down the street. Okay, good. Okay, vamos a meter solo velocidad ahora. Ya lo demás está claro. So, repeat after me. Stick walks wearily down the street. Good, okay, good, good. Now, this, hasta aquí he puesto esto de aquí porque hasta aquí llega como la primera frase, ¿no? No párrafo, no, sino frase solamente. Stick walks wearily down the street. De aquí llega acá. Repeat after me.
With
the brim.
With the brim pulled.
Okay, vamos a concentrarnos primero en ahora solamente los tonitos, okay? Repeat after me. Tan 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 ta tan tan tan
tan tan tan tan tan tan
tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan
tan tan tan tan tan tan
tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan
tan tan tan tan tan tan.
Uh-huh, good, good, huh? Good. Okay, one more time, solo sonido. Tan 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 tan
tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan tan
tan tan tan tan. Good, excellent, okay? Now, ahora vamos a poner la letrita. Steve was wearily down the street. Vamos a lanzarnos a todos acá, acá. Ni siquiera llegamos a la water watatas, pero acá va a salir una water watatas. Okay, pero practicando se limpia, se pule. Okay. So repeat after me. Steve walks wearily down the street with a brim pulled way down low. Good, good, huh? Good. Sorprendente. Okay, excellent. Excellent. Okay. Vamos a cantar esa parte, okay?
Pero ¿qué significa?
Okay. Perdón. Pero es que si leo qué significa ahorita, se van a olvidar de lo que se está enseñando. Okay. Pero okay, ratito. Practice. Se ríe. Hermes. Cuestachín. Okay. Okay, se perdieron un poquito en el tiempo. Ya, pero está bien. Algo que yo hago cuando practicaba así también las canciones, y las practico porque obviamente no sé todas las canciones, entonces mejoro el tiempo, todo. Entonces tienen que, si les sale mal, paren y repitan.
Let's go.
Okay, okay, ahí está. Okay. Okay, let's see. Voy a poner entonces para que vean. Acá hay uno que es con lyrics, con la letra para que puedan ir viendo, ¿no? Si quieren. Ahí están.
Okay.
Ahora sí. Para que lean, pero no se pierdan ahorita en la traducción. Estamos practicando pronunciation, tiempos.
Dejaste el coro, me chichi.
Vamos a ver, vamos a ver. Si hacen bien la primera parte, se van hasta el coro. Let's go.
Down the street, with a boy that ran out the window. I know. So,
Are you ready? Eso de acá, no, ready to go. Eso no. Okay, one more time, repeat. Steve walks wearily down the street with a brim pool way down low. Acá es tan 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 tan. Okay, ese es básico. Si no saben el tiempito, se pierden. Ajá, okay. So, tan 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 tan. Okay. Ajá, good. So, repeat after me. Ain't no sound but the sound of his feet.
Ain't no sound but the sound of his feet.
Machine guns ready to go.
Machine guns ready to go.
Good. It's not so difficult. Okay, arriba, okay, repeat after me. Steve walks wearily down the street with a brim pool way down low. Ain't no sound but the sound of his feet. Machine guns ready to go.
In the song, but the song
was his feet to eat. Okay, excellent. Okay, excellent. Ahí. Ya pueden cantar con Queen. Okay, y acá como dice, ¿no? Steve camina con cautela en la calle, con el ala de su sombrero abajo. Sí, no. No hay ningún ruido, solo el de sus pies. Ametralladoras listas para disparar. Okay. Okay, one more time, okay? Y vamos a... Van a cantar toda esta parte de aquí y se van a pasar a la otra y vamos a ver cómo sale.
Ouch.
Yeah, esa parte está bien. Yo creo que sí, sí sale. Ya. Yeah. Pero está bien, ahora tienen que solo seguir practicando, ¿ok? Esa de aquí, o sea, esa de aquí es chévere, ¿ok? Are you ready? Hey.
Are you ready?
Are you ready?
Hey.
Ajá, good.
Are you ready?
Okay. Okay. Are you ready? Hey. Are you ready for this?
Are you ready?
Hey. Are you ready for this?
Ajá, very good, ¿ok? Así todos. Recuerden que ese Steve está caminando, ¿no? Como todo así, como Pedrito Alemania, Pedrito Navaja, ¿no? Ustedes saben, ¿no? Así, pero en Estados Unidos camina, la diferencia.
Okay.
Ah, exactly, ajá. Good. So, repeat after me.
Mire la película.
Ah, es la película, buena, buena, ¿eh? Ok, so, repeat after me. Are you ready? Hey, are you ready for this?
Are you ready for this?
Ajá, esa sí es la parte que es rápida, esa sí es rápida. Are you hanging on the edge of your seat?
Are you hanging on the edge of your seat?
Justamente esta palabra se une, ¿no? Are you hanging on the edge of your edge of your seat? Uh-huh. Edge of your seat. Okay. So repeat after me. Are you hanging on the edge of your seat?
Are you hanging on the edge of your seat?
Okay. One more time. Are you hanging on the edge of your seat?
Henry no ha venido.
Hanging on.
Are you hanging on?
Are you hanging on the
edge of your seat?
Very good. Excellent. Okay. Tiene que darle ahí con el ritmo, pues. Okay. Are you ready? Hey, are you ready for this? Okay. Hey, are you hanging on the edge of your seat? Esa es la parte, eso es lo que va a ser más rápido. Okay. Ahora sí, les prometo, desde el inicio hasta aquí, hasta allí. Ah, bueno, hasta another one bites the dust. Okay. Y allí terminamos. Okay. Para que no se quede con el water, water, bites the dust ahí. Okay. So, let's go. Sí, es que bordar el polvo es como una persona que se derrota, se cae y está en el suelo. Es una forma de decir como que lo derrota, le gana, ¿no?
La película se llama Bohemian Rhapsody.
Ajá. No la he visto en realidad, pero la voy a ver. Buena, buena. Buena.
Sí, el cine está aquí. Chévere.
Okay. Good. Excellent. So, thank you so much. See you tomorrow.
See you.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.